वेलकम टू फिजिक्स लेक्चर। और टुडेज़ टॉपिक फॉर डिस्कशन इज स्पेसिफिक हीट। यू कैन सी हियर, आई हैव टेकन अ सब्सटेंस। दिस सब्सटेंस माइट बी सॉलिड, लिक्विड और गैस। एनी स्टेट ऑफ अ मैटर इन टर्म्स ऑफ दैट सब्सटेंस कैन बी टेकन। सो हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ दिस सब्सटेंस टू बी टेकन? 5 किलोग्राम? नो। 2 किलोग्राम? नो। इट शुड बी ओनली 1 किलोग्राम, मीन्स इट्स मास शुड बी यूनिट मास ओनली 1। नाउ मेजर इट्स टेम्परेचर, वेदर द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द सब्सटेंस इज 10 डिग्री सेल्सियस, 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस, 30 डिग्री सेल्सियस और हाउ मेनी। लेट्स से इट्स टेम्परेचर इज 27 डिग्री सेल्सियस। यू कैन कन्वर्ट दिस टेम्परेचर इन टर्म्स ऑफ डिग्री केल्विन। सिंपली एडिंग दिस टेम्परेचर इन 273, इट बिकम्स 300 डिग्री केल्विन। Now, because of this temperature, already this substance possesses certain heat. For example, it possesses heat of 10 kilocalorie. As an example, simply. Now, what you have to do? You have to increase the temperature of this substance, solid, liquid, or gas, anything, from 27 degree Celsius to 28 degree Celsius. So, what you will do? You will supply heat energy to this with the help of this flame. For example, if you supply the heat by 1 kilocalorie, it will become 11 kilocalorie. So that its temperature increases from 27 degree Celsius to 27.1 degree Celsius. Again, give more heat to it. Now the heat supplied becomes 12 kilocalorie. Its temperature increases from 27 to 21 to 27.2. So in this way, you are supplying continuously heat energy to this substance, so that the amount of heat possessed by the substance initially 10, it becomes 11, it becomes 12. Going in this fashion, for example, if the total final heat of the substance becomes 15 kilocalorie, and the temperature increases from 27 to 27.1, 27.2, and finally it will become 27.3, 27.8, and finally the temperature becomes 28 degree Celsius. So this is how you increase the temperature from 27 degree Celsius, means 300 degree Kelvin, to 28 degree Celsius, means 301 degree Kelvin. Means you increase the temperature of that substance by 1 degree Celsius simply. If the initial temperature is theta 1 and final temperature is theta 2, then theta 2 minus theta 1 change in temperature is 28 minus 27 is 1 degree Celsius. This change in temperature is called as 1 degree Celsius d theta, somewhere here. If the same thing you have done about the degree Kelvin, initial temperature in terms of degree Kelvin is 300 degree Kelvin, means it is capital T1, and finally it approaches to 301 degree Kelvin, means it is capital T2. The change in temperature in degree Kelvin is T2 minus T1, means 301 minus 300, it becomes change in temperature d is 1 degree Kelvin. What you are doing here, you are simply increasing its temperature by 1 degree Celsius here, or increases its temperature by 1 degree Kelvin here. And during this process, you increase its heat from 10 kilocalorie Q1 to 15 kilocalorie. Ultimately, you supplied certain amount of heat here. How much amount of heat energy you supplied? Already that substance possesses 10 kilocalorie, and you additional give is 5 kilocalorie, so that it becomes 15 kilocalorie. Therefore, the total supplied heat energy is Q2 minus Q1, means 15 minus 10. That is change in heat energy, means the supplied heat energy dQ is equal to 5 kilocalorie. Then this 5 kilocalorie heat is none other than specific heat of the substance. And as the substance is taken in terms of 1 kilogram, mass of the substance is unit mass, then it is called as principal specific heat. Means what? Principal specific heat is the amount of heat given to 1 kilogram of a substance to increase this temperature by 1 degree Celsius. और 1 डिग्री केल्विन इज कॉल्ड एज स्पेसिफिक हीट। द फाइनल डेफिनेशन ऑफ द स्पेसिफिक हीट और यू में से प्रिंसिपल स्पेसिफिक हीट इज द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट गिवन टू यूनिट मास ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस टू इंक्रीज इज टेम्परेचर बाय 1 डिग्री सेल्सियस और 1 डिग्री केल्विन, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज प्रिंसिपल स्पेसिफिक हीट। द मास शुड बी यूनिट 1। इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड आइदर बाय यस और सी, मीन्स यस इज इक्वल टू 5 कैलोरी और सी इक्वल टू 5 किलो कैलोरी फॉर दिस सच टाइप ऑफ सब्सटेंस। एज आई सेड अर्लियर, इफ द सब्सटेंस डज नॉट हैव अ मास ऑफ 1 किलोग्राम, फॉर एग्जाम्पल द सब्सटेंस इज जस्ट लाइक दिस, इट्स मास इज 10 किलोग्राम, देन वॉट वी हैव टू डू, देन एट दैट मोमेंट एंड इस टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेस फ्रॉम थीटा 1 इक्वल टू 27 डिग्री सेल्सियस टू लेट से 47 डिग्री सेल्सियस, मीन्स इस टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेस बाय ऑलमोस्ट 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस, मीन्स चेंज इन टेम्परेचर थीटा 2 माइनस थीटा 1 इज 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस। एंड ड्यूरिंग दिस इनिशियली इट्स पजेस सर्टन एनर्जी बिकॉज ऑफ दिस टेम्परेचर, इस इनिशियल एनर्जी इज लेट से 10 किलो कैलोरी, नाउ इट बिकम्स 25 किलो कैलोरी, मीन्स द चेंज इन हीट इज 25 माइनस 10, 15 किलो कैलोरी। सो कैन वी से दैट 15 किलो कैलोरी इज द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट सप्लाइड टू दिस 10 किलोग्राम ऑफ सब्सटेंस, सो दैट दिस टेम्परेचर चेंजेस बाय 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस और 20 डिग्री केल्विन, द सेम आंसर विल बी 4 डिग्री केल्विन ऑल्सो, देन विल इट बी ए स्पेसिफिक हीट? नो, यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ देन रिक्वायर फॉर 1 किलोग्राम, सिंपली हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ हीट इज रिक्वायर्ड टू इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर बाय 1 डिग्री सेल्सियस ओनली। दिस कैन बी ऑब्टेन बाय डिवाइडिंग दिस अमाउंट ऑफ हीट 15 किलो कैलोरी बाय दिस मास, मीन्स 10 किलोग्राम रिक्वायर 15 किलो कैलोरी, देयर फॉर हाउ मेनी कैलोरी आर रिक्वायर फॉर 1 किलोग्राम, सिंपली डिवाइडिंग 15 किलो कैलोरी बाय 10, मीन्स डी क्यू अपॉन यंग। सिमिलरली दिस 15 किलो कैलोरी इज रिक्वायर फॉर इंक्रीज इन टेम्परेचर ऑफ 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस, हाउ मेनी हीट इज रिक्वायर टू इंक्रीज इस टेम्परेचर बाय 1 डिग्री सेल्सियस, सिंपली दैट ऑल्सो कैन बी ऑब्टेन बाय डिवाइडिंग दिस 15 किलो कैलोरी बाय चेंज इस टेम्परेचर 20, means 15 upon 20, means dq upon d theta. What I mean to say, so as to obtain the amount of it required for 1 kilogram or by 1 degree Celsius, you have to divide this dq amount of it required by the mass 10 kilogram and by the increase in temperature 20 kilocalorie. That can be shown in this fashion. I would like to show that formula somehow like this. What you have to do? The specific S is equal to amount of heat, means here dq, upon mass, means 10 kilogram, upon change in temperature, means 20 degree Celsius. So its expression might be comes out to be specific heat S is equal to amount of heat required dq upon mass of the substance m. If it is not 1 kilogram, then you can determine the specific heat S by this way, into change in temperature is d theta. This is what we call it as a principal specific heat. If the substance is in terms of mole and it is 1 mole substance, and then whatever the heat is required 5 kilocalorie, then it is called as molar specific heat. Means you are representing the substance not in terms of mass but in terms of number of mole as 1 mole. Then the same heat 5 kilocalorie is called as molar specific heat. Therefore, what should be the answer? Molar specific heat is the amount of heat required for 1 mole of a substance to increase its temperature by 1 degree Celsius or 1 degree Kelvin. Simply mass is replaced by number of mole, the specific heat is replaced by molar specific heat. And the same expression can be written in this fashion, molar specific heat C equal to amount of heat upon number of, I am replacing this mass by number of mole into change in temperature, means molar specific heat representation can be done in this formula, in this way. C is equal to amount of heat required dQ upon number of mole N into change in temperature d theta. In this case, the number of mole, if for example here the number of mole are 37 mole, then you have to keep N as 37 somewhere here. So this is how you can differentiate between principal specific and molar specific heat.